CSA General Counsel member Fitzgerald John has accused his executive board of blatantly disrespecting and disregarding the constitution of the St. Lucia Civil Service Association. John is angered that the executive board has selected its own branch representatives to participate in and attend a general counsel meeting scheduled for Wednesday. He says the CSA has a duly constituted council, which according to him, was deliberately not invited to attend.
Some of these persons are general council members who are supposed to be at that meeting. You know what happened? These persons were not invited. I was invited to that meeting, but I'm not going. You understand? Because if I go to that meeting, I will only be sanctioning the irregularities that has been going on in my union for the longest while. Why weren't those persons invited to the meeting? They're supposed to be at the meeting because they're general council members. What they went about, they did was that they brought in their own persons who were not elected. This is so wrong.
The CSA Branch 2 rep claims that several names were deliberately omitted from the list of invitees in fear of those same persons speaking out against the wrongdoings of the Civil Service Association executive.
You have the Olivers, you have the Marciers, you have myself, you have these are the people who speak out on the irregularities, and they do not want the person in the midst. Okay, because we are pointing out the blunders that this pseudo-executive is doing over and over again. And it is wrong, Messi. After 64 years, that is the legacy that this present fourth executive wants to leave behind.
He says it has been over a year since a general council meeting was held where all constituted members were present. However, the CSA's acting general secretary Wilfred Pierre denies breaking any rules in the union's constitution.
All the executive members of the CSA were invited to the meeting, and you see some of them are there right now, so I don't know where that is coming. We had a meeting some time ago where we had convened a general council meeting and we thought it was properly constituted, only to find out the meeting itself, the members themselves, indicated that they were not elected at some of the branches. So that meeting had to be aborted. So what we did was to invoke a section of our constitution that gives the executive council the power to appoint a branch rep, because the branch is a part of the general council, a branch rep until the branches elect a branch rep. So that's what we have done.
Thursday's meeting was called to discuss a number of challenges facing the union and to devise strategies to address them. For the DBS Newsworld, I am Jenna Ann Gastor.